On this video, we will be demonstrating a small animal rectal exam. This will be the same for dogs or cats, just knowing that cats typically will not tolerate this if they are awake. Typically, cats need to have sedation in order to be able to do this. And of course, be more cautious in small dogs, tiny dogs, and cats so that you don't tear anything. So I'm gonna take my dominant finger, always lubricate. Lots of lubricant, that's your friend. There's nothing wrong with ever having too much lubricant. My assistant is holding the tail up for me. I'm gonna go in with my finger upright, perpendicular to the animal's hind end. What I typically do is, you know, the animal will have to somewhat relax that anal sphincter so that I can get all the way in. Once I'm in, very superficially, you'll feel both anal glands. There will be one at approximately the 8 o'clock position, which would be about right here. So I'm gonna take my thumb and my forefinger and I'm gonna gently palpate and I'm gonna feel for that anal gland. I'm feeling for any masses. I'm feeling for fullness or difficulty in expressing that anal gland. And then typically, the way I find it easier is to kind of walk over to this other side, twist my finger inside so that I can palpate the right anal gland, which will be approximately the 4 o'clock position. Same thing, feel for masses, irregularities, pain, swelling, anything like that. And then once I felt both of those, I go in a little bit further. I'm very ventral. I know you guys can't see where my finger is, but I'm gonna go very ventral against the body wall, or against the rectal wall, I should say. And I'm gonna kind of sweep back and forth. I'm feeling for the urethra. The urethra is exactly on midline ventrally. So if I make this sort of swooping position with my finger, I'm gonna feel that tube. I'm feeling for any stones, pain, masses. And actually I wanna go ahead and feel all the way around the rectal wall if I can. Again, feeling for any palpable masses, even polyps sometimes can live there, okay? And then if I can, I always try to feel up dorsally as well. If there are any large lymph nodes, you may feel them there. You can also feel parts of the spinal column, the vertebrae up there. So if the animal has any lumbar pain, you might get that in this type of position. And my final step here, after I've done a very thorough palpation here, once I bring my finger back out, I always examine the feces to make sure there's no blood, melanoma, parasites, foreign material, or anything like that.